their ninth straight win on home ice. Their sixth overall. Carter Verhaeghe with the game-winning goal. Carter, congratulations. What was the formula for success in this victory against New York?
Thank you. Yeah, I think it was just kind of stick with their plan. We know they're a really good defensive team, and it was going to be tough to get a lot of chances. But, I mean, I thought we did a good job not turning the puck over and sticking with it, kind of.
You have the game-winning goal in this evening. Your seventh. How does it develop for you around the net?
Yeah, we made a good breakout there. It was kind of a set breakout. Stevie tried to shoot it on net. I picked it up and kind of just took it to the net, and I'm happy it went in.
Describe, if you would, why that fourth line, the grind line, with Mitchell Stevens in the middle and Yanni Gord with the speed on the far wing, has continued to work so well.
Yeah, I think we got some pretty good chemistry now. We've been playing together for a couple weeks, and I mean, they're both good players, and it's pretty easy to play with. I mean, we all work hard, and I think it's been good so far.
What are you most proud of in this winning streak for Tampa Bay as it continues to roll at 18-2-1?
I think it's just we're trying to focus on the way we play. And it doesn't, I mean, the wins are nice, but we want to be good in all ends of the ice and play a full 60 minutes every night. So I think that's the biggest thing, and we've been doing a pretty good job of that.
That's a very good description of this evening. Congratulations once again.
Thank you very much.
From the last time we played them to where we're now, I think we've bought into our system a little bit more. You know, you see, I thought we did a good job of being good defensively, you know, trying to not give them much, not, you know, turning over the puck or giving them on man. So I think we did a good job throughout there. And then obviously when they did have some chances there, Vasi was there to make the saves for us.
And obviously goals are the thing that a lot of people love to cheer about, but you got a pretty nice ovation when you stop Barzal on the breakaway. Just take us through that play.
Yeah, I think I got caught there on the wrong side, and I knew I had to get back there and you know, and help out Vas. You know, you don't want to be giving him a breakaway from that far out. So I just tried my best, got a stick on it, and obviously, yeah, pretty cool feeling from the fans there to a little cheer.
At what point do you realize that's Matt Barzal and you just won the fastest skater competition over Connor McDavid, and how fast you got to be able to kind of keep up with him?
Yeah, you know, obviously when you do something wrong, I was on the wrong side of the puck there, so I knew I had to get back. But yeah, he's an unbelievable player, and you know, he has that breakaway speed there, so I was lucky enough to just get a stick on him at the end.
Calculate that through your head as you're going up the ice, trying to find the right moment to make that play.
Yeah, I was just kind of waiting for him to open up his blade there for the shot, and you know, like I said, I was just kind of lucky there to get a stick on him at the end. You know, I was running out of space there, and I knew I had to try and make a push for it. So, but yeah, I knew Vas was gonna save it anyways if he got off.
Other than the penalty, is that pretty much exactly how you guys want to play a third period when you go into it with a one goal lead?
Yeah, like I said, I think we did a good job of you know, playing the right way and being on the right side of the pucks, and you know, not really turning over the puck much in the game. So like when we're doing that, you know, we're not giving up a lot of chances, and obviously the skill takes over and we get some goals there, and Vasi makes some huge saves for us as well.
You guys are in a role like this. What's the balance between coming in confident and feeling good about your game and not feeling too good about your game?
Yeah, I think, you know, we just got to go into each game of just trying to, you know, focus on ourselves, try and be better. I think we've done that the past couple of games. Obviously, we had some pretty tough opponents here, and, you know, big test games for us. Boys are excited to play in these ones. And, you know, they pushed there for a bit, but I thought overall it was a pretty good game.
Phenomenal, I think. You know, being up, going into the third, and, you know, holding them to five shots, I think it was, and, you know, against a really good opponent. Says a lot about the way we played defensively today, and we're able to capitalize on a couple of opportunities. And yeah, very happy with the effort today.
What do you guys say about the team right now, that you are able to grind out games when you need to? One goal games are coming down to the end, and you're doing everything you need to do to get the result.
No, it's huge, and these are the kind of games, you know, that shows the growth of our team. You know, we are, you know, we can win different ways. You know, we can grind through games, and we can, you know, sometimes it's a high scoring game, but you know, this is kind of games that you're going to see a lot down the stretch. So you know, very happy with the way we answered the bell today.
Victor, when you see Anthony Cirelli make a play like you did on Barzal there, what kind of goes through your mind watching all that kind of play out?
Yeah, it was his guy, so panic play. You know, he's such a good two-way player, and you know, he made a great play, obviously, on a world-class player. But you know, Tony has done that all year for us, and, you know, I was not surprised to see him do that.
How hard is it to kind of time that and make sure you do it in a way in which you're not going to take a penalty?
Yeah, you know, you just got to make sure you wait until, you know, he puts two hands on the stick and, you know, just wait for a good timing. It's tough to explain kind of what you look for, but, you know, before the shoot, it's a puck, obviously, but it was a great play.
When you're on a kind of a roll like this as a team, how confident do you feel coming to the rink every day? Not to get too overconfident, but...
No, we know what we can do. We know what we are capable of as a team, and, you know, it doesn't matter who we play. You know, we're confident in our ability, and, you know, show that again today.
Other than the penalty in the third period, is that pretty much exactly how you want to see this team close out a game with a one-goal lead?
Yeah, actually, and I that was borderline penalty as well too. I thought he was on him, but ref saw it differently. You know, just probably a little bit of growth in our team. We played them a couple games earlier in the year, and I think we gave up five both times, and we're outchanced and out everything. And you know, it's these last three games at home, we've played three entirely different teams, and got to play different ways to win. You got to adapt, and I thought we played a simple game. You know, we really didn't turn the puck over. We didn't give them much. I think we limited to under 20 shots, and you know, aside from it was a great penalty kill. You know, they got us at the end. A kind of workmanlike effort, and boys cared about getting 2 points no matter how to do it, even if it wasn't going to be flashy, and that's what happened.
You mentioned before the game the Islanders play that playoff kind of style. Is there some pride in kind of having beaten them at their own game tonight with the tight defense?
Well, it's game 53 or whatever, 54. I'm not sure what it is, but you know, you're kind of in the dog days of the regular season. But this is where, you know, you want to just keep accumulating points. But you want to see, you know, can your team grind it out with a team that plays D? And I thought we did that. You know, we sprung Pointer there on the breakaway. You know, Swaggy got a, you know, makes a nice play out of the corner there to give us that lead. And it's, you know, a little margin for error there. We unfortunately gave up the power play goal. But for the most part, I thought we were in very much control of that game, just in the way we played. And it wasn't like we were getting a ton of chances either. But I liked, we were always on top of things tonight. And, you know, they're a good team, so they are going to create and do some things. But for the most part, I thought we handled it pretty well.
In terms of keeping control of the game, what did this Cirelli play do?
Yeah, that's it's. It's not much more you can say about Tony and his play and his just never give up attitude. And you know, that's you know, Barzal's a pretty quick little player. Obviously, we saw that at the All-Star game, and for him to track him down from behind and be able to make that play without taking a penalty is guys on the bench really appreciated that, I'll tell you that.
Cooper, talking to Point after the game, he says the team was really gelling right now. Just tell from yesterday, the guys, they really pull for each other. Seem like their attention to detail is at a season high right now. How does the psyche, how's everything going with everybody right now on all levels?
Well, our Pointer probably, you know, hit on the head there. It's it helps when you're winning. And so it's, as a staff and as a team and as a group, you know, you're putting things in place and you're being rewarded for it. And so that obviously helps. But, you know, the injury bugs caught us here last little bit, losing Roots and Mac. And for, you know, Kobe and Schenner to step in like they did and contribute, you need to have your team game going. And for guys just to slide in and out, it's been seamless transition. It's been good. Players have been really buying in.
Cooper,